In this video, we will build a planting configuration for SureDrive or SureSpeed and SureForce on an InCommand 1200 display. Building configurations and products are important as planter settings are linked to them. This allows operators to switch between different implements without having to re-enter the settings every time. To begin, tap the planting app on the home screen. Since we do not have any configurations already listed in the dropdown, we will tap the green plus to add a new one. We will use the Case Magnum 380 tractor that is already entered in the display. Tap the next arrow to select an implement. Tap the green plus to create a new implement. For the planter or seeder type, we will select planter and tap the next arrow. Use the keyboard to enter the make and model of the planter. For this example, we will make a John Deere 1760 12-row 30-inch planter. Once you have the make and model entered, tap the next arrow. Next, we will select the implement attachment type. The John Deere 1760 attaches to the rear drawbar. Tap the next arrow. On the seed rate controller screen, tap the green plus to create a new controller. In the device dropdown, select seed command, and in the device type dropdown, select SureSpeed. If your planter is equipped with SureDrive electric drives, you would just need to select SureDrive instead. Once those are selected, tap the next arrow. Enter a name for the controller. For this example, we will leave the name as the default and tap the green check. Now that our controller is built, we will verify it is the selected seed rate controller and tap the next arrow. This planter does not have split rows, so we will leave that unchecked. Tap the downforce dropdown and select SureForce from the list. The rows we will decrease to 12, and row spacing we will leave at 30 inches. Tap the next arrow. Next, we will need to enter the number of implement sections. For this example, we will leave that at 12 so that each row is its own swath section. Tap the next arrow. Tap the calculator to enter the distance from the hitch to where the seed drops out of the seed tube. Once the distance is entered, tap the next arrow. The Applications Channel screen is used if there is a liquid or granular controller on the planter. For this example, we do not have an application controller on the planter, so we will tap the next arrow. The implement name will default to the entered make and model. For this example, we will leave it as the default. If you have multiple planters of the same make and model on the operation, you will want to edit the name on each to make them unique. Tap the green check to return to the implement selection screen. Verify the correct implement is selected and tap the next arrow. If you have a multiple product unlock in the display, it will prompt you for the planting method. Selecting single variety will allow you to only have one target rate across the planter and map one variety at a time. Tap the drop-down. Two and three variety splits will allow you to divide the planter up and map two or three varieties and/or have two or three different rates at one time. For this example, we will select two variety split as we might do a hybrid comparison in this field. Tap two variety split and then tap the next arrow. Enter the number of sections for each variety split. To edit the number of sections, tap the planter side you would like to edit, and then the calculator. We will split our planter in half with six sections on both sides. Tap the next arrow. Verify the primary speed source is set to display GPS, and tap the next arrow. The configuration name will default to the vehicle name and implement name. For this example, we will leave it at the default and tap the green check to complete the configuration. Once the configuration is completed, tap the auxiliary input button. Here, we can assign the sections to switches on the switch box for manual control. Auto swath will control each section individually, regardless of how they are assigned to the switches. The switch assignments default to the left half of the planter to switch 1 and the right half to switch 2. These can be configured to the operator's preference by tapping the assign button. For this example, we will leave them at the default and tap the back arrow. Tap downforce to enter the downforce settings page. Here, we can change the downforce mode between monitor only and control. Monitor only will just monitor and record the gauge wheel load readings. In control mode, the system will make real-time downforce and uplift adjustments according to the gauge wheel load readings. The next step is to do the hydraulic bleed process. Refer to the planter frame fold installation instructions located on the Ag Leader Knowledgebase for specific instructions regarding the hydraulic bleed process. There are a few SureForce settings that need to be adjusted before operation begins that can only be accessed when an event is active on the run screen. To begin an event, tap the green check and tap the back arrow. Verify the newly created configuration is selected and tap the next arrow. Select a grower, farm, and field, and then the next arrow. On the product selection screen, you will need to select a product for each planter split that was entered in the configuration setup. We will be putting the same product in both sides and tap the next arrow. Double check the correct products are selected and tap the green check to begin the event. You will receive a calibration warning to review the seeds per revolution. This setting is covered in a separate tutorial. Tap the green check. Now, we will return to the configuration settings screen. Tap the menu button in the upper left, then tap settings, followed by configuration settings. Tap downforce to enter the downforce settings screen. Now that an event is active, the advanced tab is visible. Tap the advanced tab. Tap select all rows. We need to tell the display what gauge wheel sensor is being used. Tap load pin type. Tap the load pin type dropdown. Since we are using a John Deere planter, we need to verify which sensor part number we have installed. Tap the green check. Tap linkage type. Then tap the linkage type dropdown and select the appropriate linkage type. Tap the green check. Swipe to the left on the table to show the selected type for each row. Linkage types can be changed for each row independently. This is helpful for rows that have a different parallel linkage length, for example, around transport wheels. Tap the green check and tap the back arrow to return to the settings screen. Tap the back arrow again to return to the map screen. You will now be able to build a SureDrive or SureSpeed and SureForce configuration on the InCommand 1200 display. You are now ready to begin field operation. For more information on SureDrive, SureSpeed, or SureForce setup and settings, please refer to the feature user guide on the Ag Leader knowledge base. If you would like to see more short tutorials from Ag Leader, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.